Monday's election saw women winning big, now holding more seats in the United States Congress than ever before. Hard to believe that in the last century, we were still fighting for the right to cast our ballots, let alone be on them. On tonight's Legacy Landmarks, reporter Amy Hogan tells us what role Binghamton played in the fight for women's suffrage.
The landmark church on Court Street has seen plenty of changes since being built in 1866.
This is one of four churches in Binghamton that were designed by Isaac Perry.
For one, a name change, originally called Centenary Church. But it would be in 1913 that this building played host to an event that changed the future.
It was truly an historic gathering. It set the stage for the eventual passage of women's suffrage.
The annual New York State Women's Suffrage Convention, after a march down Court Street.
It filled this whole area.
More than 160 delegates from across the state sat in these pews, the boots on the ground of the movement, planning their strategy.
We were able to come up with the proceedings. It's a book from the New York State Museum. So we know all the meetings, all the committees that were formed.
Local suffragist Margaret Topliff was assigned as leader of the Broome County chapter of the State Suffrage Committee, and a name that would go on to appear in history books, Carrie Chapman Catt, delivered the keynote address.
And keep in mind, they had to convince men, women couldn't vote, so they had to convince men to vote for the passage of women's suffrage.
And they did. In 1915, Broome County was
overwhelmingly for women's suffrage. The bad news is that New York State wasn't.
It would take another 2 years to get the rest of the state on board, and five for the 19th Amendment to pass. It's a piece of Binghamton's past that was nearly lost.
We saw it in the paper that a landmark is about to disappear or something like that.
In 1997, Pastor Dan Little and wife Judy rescued the church from being leveled for parking. A complete stranger offered up $50,000 for them to purchase it.
We felt that was a confirmation that we were supposed to be here.
The Littles didn't find out about their church's role in the suffrage movement until last year, when a reenactment celebration was planned for the 100th anniversary of women's right to vote.
It was a lot of fun.
To ensure that history is not lost again,
we installed a historical marker out in front of this church. So now, I mean, we know, and now for generations to come, people will know how important it was, you know, what happened here.
In Binghamton, for Fox 40 News, I'm Amy Hogan.